All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Jeff Bacha. He is the Executive Chairman of Rakovina Therapeutics. And Jeff, it's good to see you. How are you?
Nice to see you, Steve. Thanks for having us.
Yeah, and also joining us is their Chief Scientific Officer and President, Mads Daugaard. And Mads, it's great to see you as well.
Great to see you, Steve.
Mads, we'll get to you in just a second. But Jeff, I thought it'd be a great opportunity for you to start off just telling us a little bit about Rakovina.
So Rakovina Therapeutics was established in early 2021. Actually, the name Rakovina is translated to cancer in Czech and some other Eastern European languages. So it's really cancer therapeutics, and that really describes what we're focused on. The genesis of the company was actually around a group in Vancouver that was very interested in establishing a pure play company in the DNA damage response field, which is a relatively new area of cancer research that has led to four now first approved products in the field, which have become very important in the terms of treatment of certain types of breast, lung, and ovarian cancer. And as with any new technology, as things evolve and come out, they're very disruptive at first, but then we start to learn about not only the good things about them, but about their limitations. And so now research is really focused on developing that next generation of products in the DNA damage response space. And so when we had an opportunity to put something together that we thought was going to be quite impactful for patients, we jumped in with both feet, and Professor Daugaard joining us to lead the science has been great. And so we're very excited about the progress that's been made in the lab and the opportunity to really make some game-changing advances toward the treatment of these very important cancers.
Yeah, absolutely. Mads, tell me a bit about DNA damage repair and how this technology works and what it all means.
Yeah, so all cells actually have the ability to repair damage to their DNA, but cancer cells in particular are very vulnerable to these types of damages. And that's because they tend to divide all the time and proliferate, and therefore they accumulate more errors into their genomes. So it makes them vulnerable to drugs that inhibit their ability to repair. And that's what we are targeting here.
So is it in essence that the cells that potentially have cancer in them or cause the damage will allow them to repair themselves? Or is the fact that you're replacing those repaired ones with newer cells? How does that part of it work?
Yes. So what happens when cancer cell cannot repair the DNA is that they will go into a suicide mode. They will basically kill themselves through a process called apoptosis or programmed cell death. And that's what we want them to do. So we want to find ways that trigger that the cancer cells commit suicide.
Okay. And where are you as far as the development is concerned? Are you in preclinical now? Where is the company?
Yes, we are in preclinical development of three different series of compounds that all tries to improve the previous generation of PARP inhibitors that Jeff told you about just before.
KT-2000, is that the most advanced one?
Right now, the most advanced one is the KT-3000 series that basically adds a new capability to these PARP inhibitors. It inhibits another enzyme in addition to PARP, and that creates a much stronger effect in terms of killing cancer cells.
Yeah. Jeff, it seems like it's a really important time for the company and the development of this right now, especially in 2023.
Absolutely. I think the progress that's been made in the lab, the team that Professor Daugaard is leading is amazing. When we started out, the idea was to take what we began to understand as limitations in the first generation products out there and come at those limitations from different angles. So assembling three different distinct classes of molecules that we could develop in parallel. And all of this work is done in collaboration with the University of British Columbia, which has been a fantastic relationship, and access to the teams there and the infrastructure has been wonderful. And it's really let us accelerate the development. And as Mads said, the KT-3000 series has emerged as sort of the leading program at the company, aimed at overcoming treatment resistance, as also moving into new types of cancers that the current drugs that are out there are not, in this field are not yet approved to treat. So in 2023, it's really about confirming that lead molecule from the 3000 series, looking at moving that toward human clinical trials, beginning to put together the paperwork to allow us to start clinical trials here in Canada, and the United States, around the world, as well as, you know, continuing to have very fruitful conversations with pharmaceutical partners. As you're well aware, as you know, companies like Rakovina advance, oftentimes there are opportunities to collaborate or partner with bigger companies. And in fact, in this field, the DNA damage response field, three of the four products in the market were, you know, the generation of big pharmaceutical companies getting involved with younger companies to advance those products and led to some big acquisitions. It's a very important product. So we're very happy to see Rakovina positioned in that place. And we're very excited about the year ahead.
Man, it sounds like it's going to be a pretty interesting one. Gentlemen, thank you so much, Matt. It's good to see you. Thanks very much and continued success in your work.
Thank you very much, Steve.
All right, there's Mads Daugaard. He's the Chief Scientific Officer and President. And Jeff, thank you as well.
Thank you. Have a great day.
All right, there's Jeff Bacha, the Executive Chairman, both with Rakovina Therapeutics.